want to simply rewire a lamp, renovate a ballroom chandelier, or change the look of a lamp with a new shade, Restoration Lighting Gallery, which is part of the Connecticut Lighting Center's family, specializes in restoring vintage lighting fixtures to their original beauty. General Manager Mark Oken says it's shade season and is here to show us how to simply or dramatically change the look and feel of your lighting. Welcome back, Mark. It's great to have you. Let's first of all talk about what Restoration Lighting Gallery is about for those who are not familiar with it.
Well, what I can say is if you haven't been in our store, you've got to come there. It's the most unique store there is in the lighting industry. We offer unique vintage lighting that we've restored, lighting we customize, and just really different American-made and European manufacturers that you're not going to see anywhere else.
And you say this is shade season.
It is shade season. And what's shade season? Everyone asks me that question. This is the time of year you get ready to get your home ready for the parties, for Thanksgiving, for the holidays. You're inviting people over more this time of year. You want to spruce your room up. You need a new lampshade. It's the best way to make a change in the room.
Now, you've brought some shades with you, so let's take a look at what you have brought.
I have. First, let me tell you, Jocelyn, on lamps, you want to make sure they're safe first before we make them pretty. So when you bring in a lamp to have it fit with a new shade, we're going to inspect it for the cord to make sure that it's not brittle, to see if the socket has been burned out. Because if you use a lamp every day, you get familiar with it, you get comfortable with it, and it works right up until it doesn't.
So people really need to check their lamps as well.
Checking the lamp is good, especially if it's something you use all the time.
Okay.
And as you can see on this piece, it's like from 1930, 1940. It's a beautiful crystal lamp. It's got a simple white shade on it, what I would call very, very traditional. And bringing your lamp in also allows us to fit that shade properly. So let me show you what can happen. Very simply, I'm going to just take the finial off the shade, and I'm going to let you take this one. And
there you go.
By either changing the harp or putting on a riser, you can make sure every lampshade is going to fit the lamp just right.
Now, when you look at this type of lamp, do you want this shape? Is this what you're looking for to balance it out?
Bell shape is nice. It does go very well with it. The previous lampshade, very traditional. This one tends to be a little more Victorian with the embossing of the pattern, the way you have a scalloped
edge. This makes a statement.
Makes a statement. Turns it very Victorian. Sits on that lamp. So you go from a traditional to a very Victorian look. Then simply, by changing the lampshade once again, you can make it very hot.
Oh, this is beautiful.
Very hip. Very different looking. Top it off with a finial, either one that complements the lamp or one that complements your lifestyle.
Now, what would you call this, the Art Deco look?
This is a very hip Art Nouveau, Art Deco-y type of look. Very, very nice with the tight-waisted shade. You can move over, and this is another thing that we do, is we'll take an object and turn it right into a lamp. So this was an old teapot that was someone's grandmother's, and what we did is we created a lamp out of it because no one's serving tea as much as they used to, but you still wanted your grandmother's lamp. We outfit it with this really cool, tight-waisted oval shade in a red that makes it pop. But let's say you want a little more sedate, a little quieter look.
Okay, we're going to change it.
We're going to change it. And also, when you notice the finial that I have here is part of the old teapot top. So we made the finial right from the teapot as well.
Totally changed the
look. Totally changed the look. Something a little more sedate, maybe goes in the corner.
Are you seeing more and more people choosing a shade with color?
Color pops the room. They really are a good way to change your whole design style or accent part of the room. Traditional white, cream, egg. Then you get into the frocks and the tight-waisted colored pieces are very, very pretty.
Okay, you have another shade for that. Is that it?
That's it for that one. And then last is this piece from the 50s, which is really a cool piece. We put a kind of a retro string shade on it to give it that early, mid-50s nuclear family.
Very popular right now, isn't
it? Very popular. String shades are very hot with people. We can change this lamp into a lot of different things. Okay. You're going to notice inside here is a reflector. That happens to be the original glass that came on the lamp. But we can change it just by putting on something with this black and white floral print.
And that's it?
And that's it. Picks up the accent of the organic accent in the front of the lamp, and it has different panels of different black and white flowers.
I didn't realize you could just put a lampshade right on top of a lamp.
When you have the reflector glass, it fits right in there, makes it easy, and we have little setups so you can put the finial right on top.
Okay.
Now let's do one more, and we're going to change this lamp once again.
Okay.
Keeping in the floral vein, we have this lampshade. It's a shade in a shade. It's the latest and hottest design out of the lighting show this past summer.
Should we say who designed it?
Well, I had a little bit to do with it.
Exactly.
And it's just a different look. It's not cheap, two shades put together. It's really one integral piece using a nice silhouette, and the white on the inside gives a whole new look to the shade.
And this is such an inexpensive way to change a room.
You make the most dramatic change with the least expense by changing your lampshades or your lamps. But the lampshades just make a pop.
Great. Thank you so much for
sharing all
these wonderful tips with us. And if you want to get in touch with Mark at Restoration Lighting Gallery, let's put the information on the screen right now as you see it. Mark, thank you again for being here.
Very good. Thank you.
And coming up next, we're approaching...